internationality project has required a huge number of lessons of hours in English and taught by mother tongue. So this is why I'm here, and in particular I take care of the fourth and fifth years. There are two different types of classes, because starting from this year we are doing 5 hours a week for the fifth years, and only 2 hours a week of English with mother tongues for the fourth years. That is the same also for the second years, because second and fourth years are kind of bridge years, and so they will start a bit more slowly. We do a lot of speaking with the kids in the class, and that's the main point, because what they really need now here is to get accustomed to the use of the language. So this is what we are trying to do in their normal school life, introducing more English language, but used practically. It's so easy for them to pick up words and expressions. It's a pleasure to to give them inputs that let them interact freely. They need to use their English with freedom, and they do it quite easily, as long as they are able to break the walls of, oh my gosh, that's a foreign language. They are quite happy to do that. We use many different techniques in class. We use theater games, we use poems, and so they can really practice their pronunciation. And then we try to let them do things and try to interact between themselves and with the teacher, but especially between themselves in English. To do that, we use also the CLIL system in science and geography. They try out experiments, and they start asking themselves and the teacher questions. Maybe questions that are a lot more complex than their grammar level, okay? But they will have to use them. They will have to ask those complex questions without thinking about the grammar, just because they need to do that, because they need to carry out an experiment for science, for example. And by doing that, their brain starts to elaborate the material they already possess and start getting used to new sounds, pronouncing new sounds. They will not feel like silly when they pronounce the R and the R and all these strange sounds, because they take it as a game, and then they prove themselves that they can do it. So it is also about confidence, self-confidence building. They will learn that it is possible. It's not a foreign, distant language, but so many people speak English in all the world, even though they are not mother tongues. And so it is like a tool that if they possess it, they can really open many, many doors of knowledge, and of also, it's a wonderful way of meeting people, of finding people you can communicate with. Communication is the key word. We try to let them experience how to communicate with another language in all possible ways.